How to prepare single column cash book? How to prepare single column cash book? Now, as discussed earlier, a cash book format is nothing but just similar to that of a ledger. The only difference being, in ledger, for this column, we give the heading as journal folio. Now, since cash book is a journal by itself, whatever we record here, the accounts, these amounts will be going into the concerned accounts in the general ledger. So, as a result, we have this column as ledger folio. Now, in the middle, you will be writing as cash book. You need not mention it as single column or double column. Now, single column being there is one amount column. As usual, there is a debit side, there is a credit side, you have date, particulars, ledger folio, and a column to record the amount. If you are maintaining with cash, you can give it as cash or you can simply leave it. The other side also you have date, particulars, LF, and cash, that is amount column. Now, always you will start your cash book with a balance. You will always start your cash book with a balance. In while preparing ledgers, we have come across in some cases the ledgers will show balance, which we will write it as a carried down balance while closing it, and write it as balance brought down when we open it for the next month or period. Similarly, you will be always given balance. If it is not given, don't search where the balance is. Sometimes you might not have any balance with you. As a result, you cannot say that always we should have balance. Now, today we are going to solve the second problem. In the second problem, the transactions are related to December 13th, and it states that enter the following transaction in single column cash book of pharma traders. Now, the first transaction is stating December 1st cash in hand. When it is stated cash in hand, it is the opening balance at the beginning of the month. So, when you have cash in hand, it is a benefit for you or a resource for you. So, the rule is all resources or assets will show debit balance. So, therefore, we give the date as 1st December and write 2, you know, which is constant, and balance brought down, and the amount being 11,500. Now, let us see what is the second transaction. On second, it is said sold goods 2,600. Sold goods, cash to sales is the journal entry, you know. Cash is coming in, so debit what comes in. So, on the in the amount column on the debit side, enter 2,600. You know 2 is constant. And what is the reason? Sales is the reason. Now, this is on 2nd December. Now, since it's an original book, actually you have to write here the narration. That is, being goods sold for cash. As a result, you are journalizing it. But generally, you don't find narrations in the solutions. It's okay if you don't write the narration. No. But in real life, you will see the cash books with narrations followed by the entry. Then, let us see what is the next transaction. The next transaction is on 5th. It is purchased furniture. Purchased furniture, 3,500. So, when you buy furniture, cash goes out. So, as a result, cash has to be credited because real account. So, on the credit side, we'll enter the amount 3,500. Now, you know there is a constant buy on the credit side in the particulars column. The reason is furniture. Cash is going out when you buy furniture. That is why you are entering it on the credit side, or we call it also as payment side. The date being 5th December. You can mention the year on top, which is common. Now, let us see the transaction of 8th. It says that purchased goods for cash. Purchased goods for cash 2000. Again, it is purchase of goods. So, when it is purchase of goods, we use the word purchases, and you know cash goes out. So, therefore, on the credit side, you will be entering the amount 2000. The constant buy and purchases. As told earlier, I am not writing the narration. The date is 8th December. Now let us see the next transaction. It is stationery purchased. It is stationery purchased. When you buy something, cash goes out. On the credit side, you enter the amount, which is 700 here, and the reason is buy stationery. The date being 10th December. Now, next it is 12th. The transaction is on 12th. It states that paid to Vasu. Paid to Vasu, you are giving cash to Vasu. So, cash is going out. So, again we have to enter this amount of 900 on the credit side. By Vasu. The date being 12th. The date being 12th. Now, let us see the next transaction on 15th. Purchased goods from Shekhar. Purchased goods from Shekhar. In this case, it is not stated we paid money. So, it becomes a credit purchase. So, credit purchase of goods are to be recorded in purchases book, which we discussed in the last class. As a result, we will not be entering this transaction of 15th, which is actually a credit transaction. So, in cash book, we will be entering only cash transaction. So, we are ignoring the 15th transaction. On 18th, it is paid telephone bill. Again, cash is paid. Again, we have to enter the amount on the credit side. The amount being 500. The reason, buy telephone expenses. Telephone expenses, the date is 18th. Now, the next transaction is sold goods to Hari. Sold goods to Hari doesn't indicate you received cash. Therefore, it becomes credit transaction. So, when it is credit sale of goods, it should be entered in sales book. As a result, we will not be entering this transaction on the debit side. We will ignore it. Coming to the transaction on 25th, it is paid interest. When interest is paid, cash goes out. So, again, you make the entry on the credit side. The amount being 250. The reason is interest. So, buy interest. Date is 25th. Now, the next transaction is on 29th. It is paid cash to Shekhar 650. Paid cash to Shekhar 650. Again, it's a payment. We'll be entering the amount on payment side. Amount being 650. The reason is the amount is paid to Shekhar, hence Shekhar's name. Date is 29th. Now, let us see the last transaction. It is received commission on 30th. The transaction is received commission. Received means cash is coming in. So, cash has to be debited. So, let it then make the entry on the debit side. The amount being 400. Enter 400. To constant. Reason of receiving 400 is commission. So, write commission. Date is 30. So, you have entered all the transactions. Since cash book is also a ledger, you find some amounts on the debit side and also on the credit side, we need to balance it.